We have reached the halfway point of the 2018 gymnastics season, and the North Carolina Tar Heels are back home in Carmichael Arena for the first time in a month, and it's a special meet, as today is the annual Pink Meet, celebrating the efforts of the Get Real and Heal program to support breast cancer survivors, as the North Carolina Tar Heels take on the Brown Bears here on ACC Network Extra. Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for joining us. I'm Brian Ware, along with my broadcast partner, Christina Chauvinet. And Christina, as we preview this meet between the Tar Heels and the Bears, this North Carolina team has really improved over the last several weeks. And on Saturday in Raleigh, they had one of the best team performances in years.
Yeah, that's right. You know, all season we've been talking about UNC wanting to get a 196. That's been their goal since week one. Saturday, they finally achieved it at the quad meet at NC State, just breaking 196 with a 196.050. They're still not happy with their performance. They had to count a fall on bars, so they're looking to improve on that, but it shows you how much potential this team has.
Yes, the potential has been there. They have been improving the last several weeks away from Carmichael Arena. They had a tough dual meet against New Hampshire. I think they competed really well in Norman, Oklahoma, a return for assistant coach Taylor Spears, who competed at Oklahoma, getting a high 195 against the defending national champions, and then coming off with this 196, their best result since 2010. You're getting to the point where now the RQS score will be tabulated. And currently, with the average, Carolina is in position, if they can keep this going, to get back to regionals again.
That's absolutely right. And when you talk about RQS, the regional qualifying score, that's going to start on February 26th. So next week, that'll start. What that is an algorithm of scores. It allows teams to drop their lower score. So you have to count your top three away scores. Then you count the next three highest scores, whether they're home or away. You drop the highest of those scores, average those five. That's your RQS. So as you say, that's one of the keys for both of these teams. For Brown and UNC, they've got some low numbers that they want to drop. UNC counting a low 194 from their home opener, and Brown right now counting a 188 from their home opener. Both those teams really want to drop that number, and that's what we have to remember coming into this, is that both teams can improve their ranking after this meet if they improve on their season averages.
Yes, Carolina comes into this meet currently ranked 33rd in the country, and as we've said, if you get into the top 36, you're guaranteed an NCAA regional spot. Brown, obviously, further down the rankings, currently 63rd in the country. But Coach Galvin for Carolina in his 37th year has to be pleased with the effort that, you know, that the team has put out. And as you said, they're striving to get better and better. And we were both down, you know, looking at the team warming up before. The confidence is there.
Yeah, the confidence is there, and you know what Coach Galvin told me before the meet is, we know these athletes are capable of hitting their routines. They really have struggled on bars the last few meets, and this is going to be a real test for them and Brown. They both competed at that quad meet at State on Saturday, so to go on two meets within a weekend is really challenging on the athletes, both mentally and physically. So it'll be interesting to see how these teams react to back-to-back meets like that.
So as you see, Carolina will be starting on the vault. Brown will be starting on the uneven bars. And this meet is going to go pretty quickly over the next 90 minutes to 2 hours. As you said, Brown has been in the triangle area. They have to quickly get back to the airport and get the flight home. So this meet may go the style of a kind of a quad meet, as once the gymnasts perform their routine and the judges tabulate the scores, they're going to send the next gymnast on, especially for Brown.
That's right. And, you know, they're student athletes. They got to get back and get back to those classes. We're going to try and keep you abreast of scores as quickly as we can. But it's going to be, again, it's going to be a real test for both these teams to see how they can react to back-to-back days. That's trying to mimic what may happen in the postseason.
So now with the 4-minute touch warm-up complete, Carolina, as you see, assistant coach Case Denick with the team. Six gymnasts perform as part of the team score. Lowest is dropped. And starting for North Carolina will be Madison Hargrave, who has really improved this year on the vault. Had a career-high 9.775 on Saturday. She's consistently been around the 9.75 mark this year.
And as you said, she has made huge improvements, really breaking into the lineup consistently for the first time this year. She really needs to work on controlling her landing. She's improved her block, but lately has been having a little trouble controlling the landing. See how she does here. Much better landing for her. Had to pike down just a little bit, so that'll be a deduction, but didn't have the bounding hop back that she has in previous weeks.
So that gets Carolina off to a solid start in the vault. And first up for Brown will be Ann Christman, a sophomore out of Amherst, New Hampshire.
A nice release move there. What we're going to be looking for on the uneven bars is for the athletes to hit all their handstands. Just a little bit of an arch in that one, and also to keep the rhythm consistent throughout their bar routine. Just a little shy on that handstand as well. And this is one of those rhythm breaks. She's going a little bit slowly into her giants, a double back dismount, and yet looks like she just ran out of gas a little bit there at the end.
And sometimes you have to, unfortunately, take those falls. As coming up second for the North Carolina Tar Heels is their star senior captain, all-around performer, Morgan Lane. She finished tied for second in the all-around on Saturday with a 39.3 against some quality gymnasts, both from NC State and from Michigan.
And this has been a little bit of an inconsistent event for Morgan this year. She was struggling with the landing earlier this season, really honed it in on Saturday at NC State. So we'll see if she can do that again here.
As we said, that in that quad meet, they faced NC State for the second time this year. And Michigan has been quite a revelation out of the Big Ten, currently ranked sixth in the country. And that's because they've been consistently getting scores in the 196s.
Exactly. And again, you know what? UNC is capable of scoring in those, in that 196, mid-196 range. What they've yet to do this season is to put it all together in one meet. So that's one of the things that they're looking to do here. I think it's going to help starting on vault, because the last few meets they've been away, they've had to start on bars, not their strongest event. Vault is a very strong event for the Tar Heels. So I think we're going to see, I think this will be really helpful for them. And they also get to finish on floor, which is one of their strongest events.
Yes, Carolina for the last several weeks on the vault have been getting scores in the low 49s.
And Morgan performs a unique vault. She's one of the only vaulters doing this in the NCAA. It's a full onto the horse, pike off, just a little step, but controls it nicely. Really cool to see her adding that innovation to the vaulting lineup.
So coming up next for Brown will be Diana Manzano.
And I actually think this is Caroline Warren for Brown.
You are correct. It's a change on the rotation. And there you see the first score coming in. A 9.825 for Madison Hargrave, a new career high.
And great to see that. Like I said, she's been working so hard on really getting that height. Now just has to work on the slight pike down that she had at the end, but a really solid performance to lead Carolina off. That's what you want from your leadoff performer, to really set the tone, let the scores build throughout the rotation.
Caroline Warren is a freshman out of South Carolina. And you also, as you mentioned earlier, before he went on air, that the coaching staff for Brown University, their expectation is to put let every gymnast perform at least one rotation today.
Yeah, that's going to be really interesting, something we rarely see from teams. All 17 athletes from Brown will be performing at least one routine in today's meet, so not competing any all-arounders, really trying to test that depth. They have the Ivy League championships next weekend, so the coaching staff told me that they're really hoping to solidify, see who's performing well under pressure, solidify those lineups. Just a little short on those first few handstands. Recovers nicely. And she's keeping good rhythm through this routine, but just some little form breaks here and there as we move to Alexis Allen on vault. And this is a powerful vault. We'll see if she can control that landing. A nice job, just that step forward. You know, we've seen her become more consistent on that vault throughout the season. That's one of the vaults that's valued out of a 9.95. So most of the vaults that we're going to see in this rotation, valued out of a 9.95. Morgan Lane and Caitlin Hedelin have 10.0 start value vaults.
And Alexis Allen has had quite the season for North Carolina this year. Especially when she performs on some of the other apparatuses. She's specifically on vault and also on the balance beam. And she had quite a performance last month for the Tar Heels, setting a career high of 9.9.
Yeah,
on the balance beam.
And she really showcases her power on balance beam as well. We've seen her become more consistent over these past few weeks on beam as well.
So third up for Brown will be Claire Ryan. On the uneven bars, she's had a season high of 9.725. Claire is senior out of Greenwood, Minnesota.
And this was the event that Brown struggled with on Saturday at NC State. Claire had a 9.575 last week. On Saturday. So they're really looking to improve on their... They got a team total of 48.35. Really looking to improve on that here. Nice Jaeger release move there. And she's really fighting for these handstands. A few small form breaks. And Caitlin's vault is one of those vaults that starts out of a 10.0. She's going to do a 1.5 twisting Yurchenko in the tucked position. This is a vault she formerly performed the Yurchenko laid out 1.5. It was a little bit inconsistent for her, so this year she's been competing that tucked 1.5, and it has really looked great these past few weeks. So she hasn't quite stuck one yet this year, but she's getting more controlled in her landing, so we'll see if she can stick this one. And we'll also be looking for her to keep her legs together through the entire vault. That's another place where she can potentially incur deductions.
Yeah, she's mostly been around the 9.8 mark. She's reached that four times this year. Had a 9.825 last week, actually 2 days ago on Saturday.
A nice job. She did have a little bit of extra power. Took a controlled hop forward. And maybe just a slight leg separation at the beginning of that vault, but she brought her legs together. That really has been a very consistent vault for her this year. And as we mentioned, this is moving more at the pace of the quad meet, so we'll try and keep you up to date as much as we can, but we will stay with Carolina when they are performing, so might see some pieces of bar routines here.
Yes, fourth up for the Bears will be Anya Olson, another senior on this Brown squad out of Michigan.
And she's a beautiful gymnast to watch on this event. Nice pike jagger right into that transition to the low bar. And maybe just a little short on that last handstand, but I like this transition into her dismount. Just a little short, but that was really the only place for major deduction in that routine.
So next up for Carolina on vault will be Madison Nettles, who had quite a career day 2 days ago over at Reynolds Coliseum, tying her career high on vault with a 9.875.
And she's really been honing this stick. We'll see if she can do it here.
Wow. And just a simple to step back, but that was very strong.
Yeah, you know, she has really improved throughout her time at Carolina. She's been honing that stick. She's capable of it. You know, she has so much power. She really has what we call the flare at the end of her vault. So she finishes her vault way above the table. Couldn't quite hold on to that stick, as I'm sure she's getting corrections there from assistant coach Marie Case Denick. But she does a good job. She couldn't quite control it, but she took a very small step back. Or as we call it, the college stick. When you salute very quickly, hope the judges don't notice that you're taking a step back.
I think they did. I see one of the scores at 9.8.
Yeah, and that's another one. This is a vault that starts out of a 9.95, so they will take off for that. But again, a really, really consistent vault for Maddie, and she can get up into that high 9.8 range when she does stick it.
And ready to perform for Carolina is Kaja Hislop, and who had a career best as well on the vault.
And she stuck that on Saturday, got a 9.925. And see, you can see she's such a perfectionist. She is not happy with that, I'm sure. But she's got such huge power that she can still get a big number even with a small step.
So back over to the uneven bars, and this is Emma Hansen.
A nice pack salto transition to the low bar there. And beautiful lines. Look at those handstands on top of the bar. And just a little bit of a stumble on her dismount. A lot of the brown gymnasts do that full pirouette into the double back. That makes the dismount more difficult because you're adding a connection bonus. But really beautiful lines throughout that routine.
Yeah, solid from the young freshman, as we do have one exhibition performance, which is Michaela Robinson.
And it'll be interesting to see here if Michaela goes. She has been competing a tucked full previously in the season, but she's been working on upgrading that to a laid out full twist in Yurchenko. So see which one she goes for here. Does the layout. Good for her. And you know, this UNC vault team is so deep. They have a lot of options on vault. So they're really just trying to get Michaela out there with get her comfortable with that full twisting Yurchenko. That's the best one that I've seen her do.
So Carolina is finished on vault, and they had another solid score, 49 in their first rotation. Four scores of a 9.825. Madison Hargrave, who set a career high, and then the back end, Headland, Nettles, and Hislop.
And, you know, I have to say, I do think that Morgan Lane, 9.625, that number feels a little low to me. I sometimes feel like the judges don't are trying to, as we move to the bar rotation, some very difficult elements in this routine.
Yes, this is from another freshman, Kate Nelson.
Nice double layout. Wow.
So Brown going with two young freshmen at the back end of their rotation. So they have had six performers compete. They do have a couple of exhibitions slated for the Bears.
And Emma Hansen with that 9.65, really strong routine. And it'll be interesting to see what Kate Nelson follows that up with. Really difficult elements in that routine. She kept good rhythm throughout the routine as well.
And it's going to be a 9.775 for the freshman out of Montera, California, as the first exhibition performance will be from Aaron Howell.
And Kate Nelson got a 9.825 last week, one of their really strong performers on that event. I love how much difficulty she packed into that routine. Nice first handstand there. Oh, too bad. She was really going for broke on that handstand, just couldn't quite hold on to it. It's one of the tricks about going for these handstands. The judges really want to see you on top of the bar, but it's a really fine line because you can sometimes... just lost control of that pirouette again. And so it's really easy to overarch those handstands. Nice recovery, good double pack dismount.
And sometimes that's the difficulty with those combining elements that obviously some of the better gymnasts can perform consistently.
Oh, it's very difficult. Anytime you're, especially on, we'll see a lot of gymnasts struggle with the handstand on the transition to the low bar, what we call bail to handstand. A lot of gymnasts struggle to get that up to handstand or overarch the handstand because you've got a lot of momentum moving from the high bar to the low bar. But, you know, that's one of the reasons that they have exhibition routines, so that they can put gymnasts who are training in there, get them some experience performing their routines for the judges, and go back in the gym and work on it.
The second exhibition performer for Brown is Gabrielle Hechtman, a junior out of Belmore, New York, who mostly competed on vault, beam, and floor as a freshman. She's only competed only a few times this season on the uneven bars.
And, you know, as I mentioned earlier, on Saturday at NC State, they did struggle a little bit on this event. No major breaks, no falls, but just giving away tents here and there on handstands and form issues. So that's probably part of the reason why they're trying to get some of the gymnasts into these exhibition positions so that they can sort of test the depth of their lineups and see where they want to be as they move into the latter part of the season. And just a little leg separation there as she goes into her piked Jaeger. And that's another one of those places, again, that transition to the low bar can be really tricky. She loses her form, legs come apart there a little bit.
Madison Nettles and Kaja Hislop, as well as Madison Hargrave.
Yeah, and this was a strong rotation for Carolina. You know, it's not their full potential. They are capable of sticking some of those vaults, and we saw that on Saturday at NC State. But I think what's really great is they're getting so consistent that even when they're not sticking vaults, they can still hit a 49.
Yes, 49.025 is Morgan Lane with a 9.725 into the score, and Brown unfortunately had to take a fall as they have a score of 47.775 on the uneven bars.
Yeah, and you know, with Brown, they really did struggle with some of those rhythm issues throughout the rotation. Really nice to see them finish strong, though, on the bars with Kate Nelson getting that 9.775. Lots of difficulty packed into that routine. So it's just an issue. They have the skills are there. They have difficult elements in their routines. It's just an issue of getting them a little bit more consistent.
And as Carolina will move over to the uneven bars. So far this season, as we've said multiple times, this has not really been Carolina's strongest event. I mean, they had their best score was, they've only been in the 49s once, and that was in the meet at New Hampshire. Other than that, they've had to take, you know, either a fall or some poor combining elements into those scores, and they've mostly been in the mid-48s.
That's right, and I talked to Coach Galvin about that. I said, what are your goals for bars? And he said, well, you know, our athletes are performing these routines well in the gym. We just really need to translate it to the meet. And so the one thing about Carolina, they don't have as much depth on this event as they do on some of the other events, so they're really relying on the athletes that are in the lineup to hit their routines. All very capable of doing it, just haven't all put it together in the same meet, save the meet at New Hampshire. So that's one of the key things for them, hitting 196 or even getting into that mid-196.
And as we've said about, you know, where Carolina is positioned so far, their team average is currently at 195.19. You know, getting into that, the top 25 is not that far off. The difference between where they are and where
Carrie Underwood,
teams like NC State and George Washington
Beyonce,
are, is an
Cardi
average
B,
of
Rihanna,
you know, just over
Logic, Kendrick
about
Lamar.
3/10 to 4/10 of a point. And with the way that, you know, the conference is set up in the East Atlantic Gymnastics League, all these other teams, GW, who's the defending champion, New Hampshire, you know, got a 196 against Carolina. NC State had a season best 196.575. Carolina getting into the 196s. Pitt is just a few spots outside of getting back to regionals. It's going to be a big fight for that conference championship because anybody can win that.
That's right. This is a really strong year for EAGL gymnastics. So as well as Carolina has been doing, they're going to have some heavy competition at the EAGL. Same thing with Brown as they move into the Ivy League Classic. A lot of the Ivy League schools are clustered around the same rankings in the same range. So they're really looking to that next weekend. Brown, as we said, ranked 63rd at the moment, statistically unlikely to make it to regionals at this point, but they are eligible to compete in the USA Gymnastics Collegiate National Championships, which are for teams that have less than 6 athletic scholarships. So that includes all the Ivy Leagues, Division II schools. So they're looking to that for the postseason as well. They qualified last year, so the regional qualifying score will be used for that as well.
And they've had some solid performances over the last several years in terms of the conference, the ECAC that Brown is in.
Yes.
Caroline Morant, who graduated last year for Brown, was a conference champion, a multiple conference champion in different apparatuses. She was, as a freshman, she won the all-around. As a senior, she won on floor exercise on that day.
Yeah, that's right. And Anya Olson, who's one of their seniors, placed second on bars at last year's USAG Collegiate National Championship. So again, they're looking to drop a low number from their season opener. So both teams could come away today with an improved RQS if they can hit all four events. And Brown does need to make up some ground here on vault. One of the things we'll see from Brown, we're not going to see as many of those really high start values because they will be performing, as we see there, the Yurchenko layout. Really nicely done there. That does start from a 9.75, so that's the maximum score that you can get for that vault if it's performed perfectly. And she did a really good job there, our leadoff performer, Ann Christman.
And first up for the Tar Heels on the uneven bars is Madison Nettles.
And this is the critical point in her routine. Her Jaeger right into this. Couldn't quite see her legs on that, but she did a good job transitioning. Sometimes struggles there. Good last handstand. And she is usually money on this dismount. Just a small step on that double layout, but that's why they put her up first. She hits in any situation.
Yeah, she had the best score for the Tar Heels on Saturday with a 9.825. As you get a look at Diana Manzano of Brown, who will be second to perform, a sophomore out of New Braunfels, Texas.
And what we'll see from Brown is we'll see they do have some of the more difficult vaults later in their lineups. Teams tend to put up their more difficult routines later in the lineup, hoping that scores will build. I believe we're going to see another laid-out Yurchenko from her. Nicely done, just a little pike in the hips throughout that, so they will deduct for that, and obviously the step on the landing. That's probably a 1/10 step.
Next on the uneven bars will be sophomore Mikayla Williams. And Mikayla, so far this season, has mostly competed on the uneven bars this year for Carolina.
And she missed that release move in warm-ups. Started a little bit there, but recovers nicely. Good to see her fight through that. Nice final handstand. And she also has a double layout dismount. And just a small hop. You know, it's good to see her fight through that struggle. She could have very easily come off on that Jaeger, but held on to it.
Yeah, she got a lot of power off the high bar on that double layout.
And, you know, the reason it's important to see your athletes fight through this because that hopefully they could drop that score, but you don't know what's going to happen later in the lineup. So good for her for sticking with it and managing to hold on and finish her routine strongly.
Next up to perform for Brown is Gabrielle Hechtman, who will be scoring for the Bears. She's had a season high of 9.575 this year.
A nice vault. That vault is valued out of a 9.9, so higher start value than some of the other vaults that we saw. She was just a little short, had to take that step back, but good job overall.
And third up to perform for the Tar Heels is Morgan Lane, who had a 9.725 on the vault earlier.
And one of the things we'll see from Morgan, her routine actually doesn't start from a 10.0 like the other gymnasts in Carolina's rotation. Her routine starts out of a 9.9 because she gets a 0.1 up to the level deduction because she does not have a major release move. They were working one, but it was a little inconsistent, so she stuck with this routine. But the great thing about it is she's so clean. I mean, you can see this. Look at these handstands. This is code of points handstands, and she is, and her toe point is just exquisite. Her lines, her legs glued together. She really maximizes on that execution. Has had trouble sticking this dismount. Oh, and just hangs on to it. They may take a little bit of a deduction there, but a nice laid out Yurchenko there.
As you quickly saw the fourth performer on vault being Anya Olsen. As Carolina will next send up Caitlin Headland. And unfortunately for the Tar Heels last week, it was Headland that had to take a fall. And that was one of the scores that Carolina had to have in their team score. But Caitlin Headland, over her career, has really starred on the uneven bars.
She is a beautiful gymnast to watch on this event. I talked to Coach Galvin about her fall last week. He said, you know, she was just being really aggressive. He wasn't worried about that fall carrying over to this week. She's a really powerful gymnast and is one of those gymnasts that can really work, use that to her advantage on this event. Really the highlight of the routine that we'll see is her dismount. She has a full twisting double back, and she gets so much height and distance on the dismount. And looks like there's just a judging conference, so we'll move to Julia Green. This is one of the one of Brown's really strong athletes. She's going to be doing that front pike as well. Wow, great job. Just that small step, maybe a tiny bend in the knee, but she has really good dynamics on that vault as we move to Caitlin. Just a little leg separation on her bail, but does a better job than last week. And now she just got that dismount. Like I said, she's got huge power. Wow. I'd say she redeemed herself from last week.
Yes, she did. And that performance is probably going to be close to her season best. She hasn't really been able to crack that 9-8 score.
And those are the stick shades, Brian. You remember the stick shades?
Yes, we do.
Yeah, so we'll be seeing those throughout the night. If you stick a dismount, you get the stick shade. So I think that's the first stick shade of the evening.
And it looks like the sixth performer for Brown on the vault will be Kate Nelson. Alyssa Gardner.
And she's going to be performing, I believe, a full twisting Yurchenko. So that's going to be the vault with the most difficulty in their lineup. This is valued out of that 9.95. And she did a good job on that landing, just a little bit low. But she pulled her chest up pretty quickly and had to pike down a little bit as well. But that vault is worth 0.2 more than the laid out Yurchenko. So that it's really great to see them throwing that difficulty.
I said just a moment ago that Caitlin Headland, that last performance was probably her best of the season. It is a score of 9.85. As you get ready for the sophomore, Grace Donaghy.
You must have ESP with the judges. And this is a critical routine. She's a beautiful athlete to watch on this event, but she's struggled the last few weeks on this release move here. See if she can catch it too far from the bar. That's really too bad to see. As I said, she's really beautiful on this event, but has been struggling with that release move.
And unfortunately, with this fall, it now puts what the performance that Mikayla Williams had now into the team score.
That's right. And they still have one athlete to go, Alexis Allen, in that sixth spot. So she, again, has to get up and finish her routine. You'll see what I'm talking about, just a little short on that handstand. Sometimes when you fall, it can be it's hard to get back up and really fight through. And you tend to be a little bit more conservative on the rest of your elements so you don't fall again. Nice double layout. She's got beautiful qualities on this event. Hopefully she can make that release move more consistent as the season goes on.
Yeah, unfortunately, it's been stuck in her head. This is now the third straight meet that she has failed to complete that element.
Yeah, and, you know, like I said, though, she's a beautiful athlete. She got a 9.85 when they were up at New Hampshire. Really one of those athletes that is just a natural bar swinger. So I know she's going to be working on that towards the latter half of the season.
So now we get ready for Alexis Allen, who will be the sixth performer for the Tar Heels on the uneven bars.
And just here some score updates for you. You saw Julia Green in that five spot for Brown with that nice front pike, 9.725. Well deserved there. And just a little bit shy, Brown's just a little bit shy of their mark of 47.825 at NC State, but solid performance for them on ball.
Those judges still tabulating Grace Donahue's score. And unfortunately, this is going to be the one that hopefully that Carolina drops.
And, you know, this is a real pressure situation because given that Grace fell, now they really want to be able to get through the rotation without having to count a fall. So, you know, Alexis is relatively new to the bars lineup. She did a few exhibitions last year, but
she's only done it twice. Got an official team score twice this season.
That's right. She's been competing in exhibition, but hasn't done full routines in the lineup very often. Lacked a little amplitude on that to Kachev, but
she got the effort in.
Exactly.
She was fighting for it.
Exactly. And if there's one place that she tends to struggle, it's on her dismount. Sometimes her endurance can be a factor, so we'll see how she does here. She's capable of doing it's a beautiful double layout. Nicely done. Good for her handling the pressure. Just that step on the dismount and a few minor form things within there. But she's a strong bar worker. I think we're going to see her continue to improve. And hitting in those pressure situations, that improves your confidence as you move forward. So really, really important step for her. And, you know, the Tar Heels made it through without having to count a fall. So that's a big step for them as well.
And again, it also mentioned, you know, the times that you said that Carolina doesn't have all that much depth on this apparatus.
Yeah.
As they have one exhibition performance. It's Rain Gordon. And Rain has been in and out of the rotation so far this year for the sophomore, though she did compete and score in the New Hampshire meet with a score of 9.825.
Rain trained at Chris Waller's Gym Jam in Los Angeles, also the assistant coach at UCLA, and she told me that she grew up going to the UCLA gymnastics meets, and that was part of what inspired her to want to come and be part of collegiate gymnastics.
So hopefully with the way that Carolina has been performing the last several weeks on the uneven bars, this is again an opportunity to get back into the rotation.
That's right, and I do think the home order really benefits Carolina because they start on a strong event of theirs, which is vault, and they end on their absolute strongest event, which is floor exercise, and that's really beneficial for them. I think it gives them confidence going into bars. And again, this is just, you know, it's important for them to be, they're putting up all of their routines and including Reigns just to give them options for lineup changes as they go later in the season. Nice first handstand there. She can sometimes struggle on her handstands as she moves it to her Jaeger. Good job there. Just a little shy on that handstand and shy on that handstand as well. And the judges will take a deduction for each handstand that is short. But last handstand was a lot better. And moving in again, she's got a double layout. Wow, stuck dismount. Good for her.
And as the team surrounds her,
you know, she just had a few form issues to work through.
There it is, the stick shades.
Yeah, that's really what it's about. You know, she might not have hit all of her handstands, but it's not a handstand shade. It's the stick shade. So that's the most important thing about the rotation.
So Carolina with these scores tabulated, they got a 48.650 on the uneven bars.
And, you know, that's definitely not where they were hoping to be. It is an improvement over where they were last, or on Saturday. I keep saying last week because it's rare to have two meets so quickly. But Saturday, they got a 48.2. So it's an improvement on there, not quite where they need to be. Again, just a lot of form issues that need to be fixed in that bar rotation. But they got through and they improved their score. So that's great for the Tar Heels.
So now Carolina will transition to the balance beam
above the ground and measures only 4 inches wide. It requires you to take tumbling skills that you would normally do on the floor and do it on the only 4-inch wide beam. I really enjoy beam because it takes a lot of concentration, but there's no better feeling than when you get off the beam without having wobbled and stick the dismount. On beam, the judges are looking for powerful tumbling, good rhythm, full splits in your leaps and jumps, and graceful dance.
Trump, Obama, George Washington, Abraham Lincoln.
We're back here at Carmichael Arena as the Tar Heels and the Brown Bears are competing in the annual Pink
Washington
meet
Adams
for the
Jefferson,
Get
Madison,
Real
Monroe,
and Heal
Adams,
program,
Jackson,
a great
Harrison,
program
Tyler,
here at the
Taylor,
University
Fillmore,
of North
Pierce,
Carolina
McCann,
for
Lincoln,
breast
Green,
cancer survivors.
Arthur Cleveland,
as
Harrison
both teams
Cleveland. I don't know the rest, but then there's Obama.
Pink
Bush
leotards for today's occasion. And Carolina so far has had some solid routines, a score of 97.675 after two rotations, a solid 49, low 49 on the vault. And where it was in the mid 48s on the uneven bars.
That's right. And, you know, I think Carolina didn't quite do what they wanted on bars yet. They had some form issues throughout the rotation, but what they did do was they were able to get through the rotation without counting a fall on bars, which they've had to do the last few weeks. So we're seeing Morgan Lane's routine here. And, I mean, look at this form. It is really unbelievable. Everything is picture perfect. Legs fully extended, toes. I mean, this is toe point 101 right here. And just beautiful double out. The only thing is she did hang on to that stick, probably incurred a slight deduction for her arm swings. Just one, you know, one place where they did struggle was Grace Donahue missing that Jaeger release move again. Such a beautiful athlete on this event. And I know that we're going to see great things from her in the future. Just going through a little bit of struggle with this skill. And she was just way too far from the bar. And Alexis Allen here coming back and hitting this routine under pressure. I think she can be really proud of that.
Yeah, she got a 9.725. And as you see from that angle, she fought every single tenth of that routine.
And, you know, she was a little bit tentative at places in the routine. I think that's natural when you're following a fall because you really want to make sure that your team gets a hit. She needs to be a little bit more aggressive on some of those handstands, but she did a great job. And it was one of the better dismounts that I've seen her do this year as well.
So Carolina will be first here on the balance beam, and leading things off is the senior captain, Caitlin Headland, talking with assistant coach Taylor Spears, who was a national champion on the balance beam during her time at Oklahoma, winning the first of multiple national championships that Oklahoma has won over the past several years. And
she's done a great job with this UNC beam team. Caitlin is a beautiful athlete to watch on this event. As you see her series there, back handspring layout, step out. Great job. A lot of confidence going into that. She is, you hear the floor music in the background. Again, we're sort of moving at quad meet speed. And just a little hesitant on that aerial. She did connect it. I think she will get that connection for connecting it to the beat jump. That is a place where if the judges determine that they did not make the connection, they can get deducted. They can take a deduction from their start value, excuse me, because that's how gymnasts build their start value. Beautiful turn there in attitude. I love that she does a little bit of a different turn than we typically see. She just got her dismount left. She's got a one and a half twist. Oh, and almost stuck it again. I think it's one of those college sticks. Really solid routine. You know, she has a little thing she can work on here or there, but she's been really consistently getting Carolina off to a good start on that event, and that is really important, especially on balance beam.
The first performance you're seeing here on floor exercise is from Ann Christman. Christman is a sophomore.
And whipped 1.5, just a little shy.
But she's done well for the Bears. She started out strong on the vault in the last rotation, and now she's getting brown on the board first here on floor exercise.
And Brown has a lot of difficulty in their floor routines. So good to see them performing those. And it's kind of interesting for these two teams to be competing in this sort of quad meet format, even though it's only a dual meet, because, again, this is what the postseason looks like. This is what the Ivy Classics look like, the EAGL Championships. So it gives them sort of a good test on that, because when you're going on beam at EAGLs or at regionals, there's going to be floor music in the background. So it's probably a good thing these two teams are mimicking quad meet format in two meets in 3 days.
There you see Lily Dean, one of the young freshmen out of North Andover, Massachusetts, who has mostly competed on vault and on balance beam this season.
And she's been in and out of the balance beam lineup. She has some great qualities on this event, but has been a little bit inconsistent. Oh, and just didn't have that right. That right foot was not on at all. Can't hang on to it. Very difficult element there, that punch front. Nice switch side leap there. And it seems like she's just lost her confidence here. One of the challenges about balance beam, after you have a fall, sometimes you tend to be a little bit more tentative, and that can actually work against you on balance beam because you really have to be aggressive and go for those landings.
And it's usually been that in this spot, it's usually been either Lily or another young freshman in Riley Dewhurst in the two hole in this balance beam rotation.
A nice recovery there. Good to see her recover with that dismount, but that is a routine that Caroline is going to look to drop.
Now competing for Brown on floor exercise is Rose Domanosk, a freshman out of Park City, Utah.
Oh, and she is out of bounds, and she landed out of bounds, which means she's probably going to incur about a 3/10 of a deduction because both feet are out of bounds and she landed out of bounds as well. One of the challenges with those multiple salto passes is, you know, sometimes the gymnasts can really find themselves running out of room at the end there, and if they have any extra power, it's really easy to go out of bounds. That is a requirement in floor routines. The gymnast must have at least one pass where they're doing two different flips in the same pass.
So third up to perform for Carolina will be the sophomore Rain Gordon. You just saw a moment ago in an exhibition performance on the uneven bars.
And she's been really getting into her groove on beam these last few weeks. Got a 9.825 at NC State on Saturday, and then the week before at Oklahoma also got a 9.825. So this is going to be a big test for her following a fall. Really important to set Carolina back on that right track.
Yes, she matched her season best.
And one thing to watch here is her connections on her leaps. Sometimes she can be a little bit slow in doing the connections and need to make those really crisp to get credit for it. She will get credit for that aerial to back handspring series. Very well done. And really nice, you know, she was a little bit off there, pulled herself back really quickly. Good to see her working through that. It shows that she's confident up there. I love that double stag jump. Just something different that you don't see every day. And she has a gainer pike dismount off the end. We'll see if she can stick it. Wow.
Yes, she did.
And that is exactly what they wanted. That's right up there with her routine from state last weekend. So we'll see how it scores, but really what Carolina needed right now.
Third up for the Bears is Diana Manzano on floor exercise. And Manzano is competing for the first time in the rotation here on floor exercise this season for the Bears.
And she's a little bit low on that front layout, but recovers nicely. Nice double pike. And a good rebound routine for Brown as well, coming off that routine where they had an out-of-bounds. Really solid double pike at the end of that routine. Sometimes you see gymnasts struggle with their endurance a little bit at the end of the routine. Definitely not the case there.
There you get a look at Alexis Allen, who is next to perform for Carolina on beam.
And Alexis is capable of being wonderful on this event. She really has beautiful lines, has great extension through her leaps. It's really just consistency that she's struggled with. She has been, over the past few weeks, building that consistency. So, again, I mean, this is a big test for them, because they may get in a situation at the EAGLs or regionals where they have to go up after somebody has fallen, and it is a must-hit situation.
We said earlier this year, in the meet against Temple.
Oh, gosh. And, you know, she was being really aggressive, going for that full split. And just her heels were too off center. And she's recovers nicely with that series. Oh. And mistakes like that, when you see a gymnast bobble on choreography, that's just a little sign of nerves kicking in. Recovers nicely on that full turn, though. She's working through it. And she's just got her dismount here. Gainer full. Just that little hop. Good to see her recover. You know, she did have a fall. She was being aggressive, though, so I think that's something that they can be proud of. She was really going for broke on that leap.
Now over on floor exercise is Anya Olson.
And check out this first pass. Oh, and does her front layout to front pike. Nicely done there.
Olson, one of the better performers for Brown on floor exercise. It's been consistently in the 9-7s.
She's got a lot of power on this event. Good 1.5 to stag jump there. Double stag jump, excuse me. And I think we just missed her first pass, but she's one of those really powerful athletes for Brown. And has a lot of... She's a natural twister. As all of her passes have multiple twists in them, which is really cool to see.
And now fifth up for the Tar Heels is Kaja Hislop, and she has been sensational over her young career on the balance beam. Last year as a freshman, the EAGL Freshman of the Year, was the number one gymnast in the conference on the balance beam. And in the last 2 weeks down in Norman and at Reynolds, she has set her new mark of a 9-9 with this routine.
That's right. She's a beautiful gymnast to watch on this event. She is really powerful on vault and floor, and showcases that here as well. She's got such great extension on her leaps. She really hits that 180 in her leaps and kind of hangs out there just to let the judges know, like, I got this. And here's her series, front arrow to back tuck. And that's the critical place for her in the routine. Does a great job there.
As you said, when it comes to keeping that momentum going in terms of the combination of elements.
That's right. It's really critical for the gymnast start values. And look at this. Look at the extension on that split. She leaves the judges absolutely no option but to not deduct there. And, you know, she had a new dismount earlier this year. It was a little inconsistent for her, so they changed her back to her dismount from last year. She's got a punch front Rudy. Great to see her stick that. That's a really strong recovery routine for Carolina.
Getting the Tar Heels back on, back in front here, as they've had to, they now have to take one fall into their team score. As you see for Brown, Julia Green.
And this is another one of those powerful athletes. Nice job on that middle pass there.
She had a solid, the best performance for the Bears on vault. And she is the Bears' best performer here on floor exercise.
Look at that double back. Great height. And she does that double back out of a round off. Does not do the back handspring. She packs a lot of power.
Yes, she had a season best of a 9.8 here on floor exercise not too long ago. As the final, as the sixth performer for Carolina is going to be their senior, Morgan Lane.
And, I mean, honestly, I've run out of adjectives to describe Morgan Lane. She is so beautiful on this event. She's ranked 28th on beam in the country. She hit her career high at Oklahoma, 9.95. And what really sets her apart is not only her form, but this mount right here. Look at this press handstand. We're just going to hang out here for a minute. And then right into two layout step outs. Beautiful. She's the only person doing that in the country.
And that was something that, that first, you know, element, that's something that she constantly focuses on during the, you know, the pre-match warm-up and the touch warm-up,
and
is
look,
being able to get up.
That's right. And I mean, and it's in, and she continues that throughout the rest of the routine. You know, every element is finished on releve, that full turn. And even, you know, she's a little bit off on that side summy, but she can just correct for things so easily on beam. And she's got a 1.5 for her dismount.
Going right to Coach Galvin. Solid dismount.
Wow.
Solid routine for Carolina to finish up here on the beam.
You know, they had some hiccups in the rotation, but really recovered nicely. And it's great to see their athletes later in the lineup hit under pressure.
Competing sixth for the Bears is Anya Barca-Hall, who's a senior from Santa Cruz, California. And this is the only event she competes in for the Bears. As we said earlier in the broadcast, that every gymnast will perform at least one rotation in this meet today.
Nice 1.5 twist to front layout there. Beautiful job.
So Brown finishing strong on floor exercise after Julia Green's 9.8.
And they've had some strong, after their fall earlier in the rotation, they've had some really strong scores come back for them. And this is Jamie DiCiccio. And she has not been in the lineup much. She has seen action mainly in the exhibition position. Oh, and good for her fighting to stay on. Nice pike jump. And, you know, she's showing a little bit of nerves through this routine, being a little tentative at places, but it's great to see her fighting through that and staying on the beam. And she's got beautiful extension in her leaps and jumps as well. And she's got a gainer pike to finish as well. Nice duck landing there.
Good finish for DeChico as Morgan Lane gives her the stick shades.
You know, that's
Carolina was now finished on the balance beam as we have a couple of exhibition performances from Brown. But as you were saying, Christina?
No, just, you don't need to wait for the scores when you get the stick shade. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's the important thing.
First exhibition performance is from Maggie McAvoy. McAvoy is a senior out of Charlotte, North Carolina.
Nice front layout to front full there, fulfilling that double salto connection that I was, multiple salto connection that I was mentioned earlier. Really nicely performed routine there.
So it looks like Brown only has one exhibition performance, as it looks like both teams are switching over to their next rotation as Carolina will move to floor exercise momentarily.
And, you know, I think Brown can be really proud of the job that they did on floor. Huge improvement from what they did at NC State. 47.675 at NC State, 48.550 today. That back of the lineup, a lot of power.
My apologies. The second exhibition performance is from Morgan Hagenbuch, a junior out of Norwich, New York. Be the second exhibition. Again, the juniors looking to make a significant statement as she has competed the last few years for Brown, yet has not really been in the rotation this year.
And, you know, that's one of the things that these exhibition routines is important for the individual athletes. You have to remember that there is internal competition within teams for spots in the lineup. So if an athlete performing an exhibition goes up there and hits their routine really well, that may be an opportunity for them to get into the lineup as we move into the last part of the season.
Hagenbuch competed primarily on floor, had a season best of 9.675 last year as a sophomore.
And the score came in for Morgan Lane there on beam, 9.825. I gotta say, that feels a little low to me. Front layout to front pull combo, very popular with this Brown gymnastics team. Just a little sidestep on that landing. Nice Rudy there to finish.
A good finish for the Bears on floor exercise. That 48.55. And after three rotations, Carolina with a score of 146. Brown with a score of 144.1 as the Tar Heels will transition over to floor exercise. Brown will move over to the balance beam. And expect to see some fireworks here on floor exercise for the Tar Heels on the other side. We'll step aside for a moment. Here on ACC
exercise is one of my favorite events. It's at the very end. The gymnast gets to perform in front of the crowd and get them involved. On this event, each gymnast picks out their own floor music and has their own dance style to it. They have explosive tumbling. The gymnast balances the difficulty of their tumbling with the artistry of their dance, and the judges are looking for great presentation, great execution. Specific deductions are taken when the gymnast steps out of bounds or is out of sync with their music.
www.tarvillegymnasticscamps.com. Okay, Nantucket, Carburitos, One Fish, Two Fish, Panera, Med Deli, Four Corners, Carolina Brewery.
Okay, Spicy Nine, Panera, Noodles and Company, Chipotle, Purple Bowl, Cafe, oh frick, I forget what it is, Benny's, Sup Dogs.
We're in the home stretch here at Carmichael Arena as North Carolina has tallied 146 points through the first three rotations. Brown has accrued a score of 144.1. So both teams are getting to the rotation where they had one of the best team performances of the season. Brown had a season best 48.6 on Saturday in the quad meet. Meanwhile, Carolina had one of the most impressive team performances on floor exercise in recent memory with a team score of 49.425, which was their best performance since 2010 as a team, and it was from their back three performers, Morgan Lane, Madison Nettles, and Kaja Hislop. And Carolina so far this season, as we said, has been one of the best teams on floor exercise in the country.
That's right. They've been so dynamic all season long. And last on Saturday when they were at NC State, it really just all came together. The landings were so crisp. That's one of the things we have to keep talking about with this Carolina floor team. There's so many powerful athletes. They really have to focus on controlling their power, honing those landings. Last week, they had three athletes go 9-9 or above. They're hoping to continue that this week. They know they're capable of it. And at this point in the meet, they really need it. They haven't performed up to their potential on balance beam or the uneven bars, so they really need a strong floor performance here. And as you mentioned, last week, or on Saturday, Brown did a great job. They had to start on beam. That is a tough task. And they got their season high at NC State. So now they have to finish on it. That's another tough task. Coming from floor exercise, you got a lot of energy. You got to harness that for balance beam. And Brown has a lot of difficulty, and they also have unique skills in their routines. So we'll look forward to seeing that.
Yes, especially at the back end with Julia Green, who's been solid for the Bears today. And also Regan Butchness, who will be performing fifth for Brown, specifically a balance beam specialist. And first to perform for Brown is Claire Ryan.
And she went 9.725 against NC State.
Which is her career best, and she fought through that first element.
There you go. And that's her acrobatic series required element in the routine, as that full turn is.
And we're going to transition to Carolina on floor exercise as Madison Hargrave has fought her way into a spot in the rotation. Got Carolina off to an excellent start with a 9-8 on floor exercise. The junior has been put into the rotation the last 3 weeks. In this number one slot.
nice double pike in the middle there. Maybe a large lunge out of it, so the judges may take a little deduction. Solid 1.5 to front layout. Great start for Carolina.
So, looks like we have a judges' conference over here on the balance beam. Is You see a junior, Cassidy Jung, junior out of San Marino, California, competing in the only event today. As we said, we're going to see a couple more people competing for Brown in their only event of the day. And I got to give a lot of credit to the coaching staff. As you mentioned earlier, deciding to make this kind of a move led by Sarah Carver-Milne.
Yeah, and you know, I think it's an important time in the season to really be testing lineups, seeing where people can slot in, because you really do want your strongest and most consistent competitors as you head into the postseason.
So as Jung performs, we also have the young freshman, Lily Dean, ready to perform on floor exercise. And just seeing the score a moment ago, Madison Hargrave having a career day here for the Tar Heels, a 9.825. She set two career highs today, both on vault and floor exercise, Christina.
And good for her. She's been increasing her consistency as we see Lily Dean's first pass here. And she's a really powerful athlete, sometimes has trouble controlling that power, but good first pass there.
Lily Dean has been solid this season for the Tar Heels. Mostly getting around that 9.8 mark. She's had a 9.825 on three separate occasions. And the final pass in front of Coach Galvin. Carolina's momentum is building here on floor exercise.
And that's going to come close to hitting that number. You know, I mentioned at the top of her routine, she's one of those gymnasts that has a lot of power. That's a good problem to have, but really has been working on honing those landings because the judges are very particular. You really need to show complete control in your landing before stepping into that lunge. Otherwise, you will incur a deduction. She went out of bounds on her floor routine against NC State on Saturday, so good to see her recover from that.
Judges calculating scores for Cassidy Jung, who was competing on the beam as we shift back and forth. As we said earlier, this meet the style of a quad meet as the Brown Bears are going to try their best to get back to Raleigh-Durham Airport and head back to Providence, Rhode Island.
And Cassidy did have a fall in that two spot. So this is another pressure situation like we saw with UNC.
As we get a look now at Michaela Robinson on floor exercise.
And Lily Dean scores in 9.875. So two career highs and two routines.
Yeah,
not a bad way to start the rotation.
And Michaela had a career day on floor exercise against Temple with that 9-9, and she's been hitting her stride this season for Carolina, the sophomore.
Big power on that double pike.
Like she stayed in.
Really?
Neither judge raised their hand.
Yeah,
that's just the power that Robinson has had, and it's going to be another solid score for the sophomore.
Yeah, and you know, that's, you know, one of those things that comes with that experience of competing week in and week out is being aware of where you are next to the out of bounds line. Really important. You could tell she kind of shortened the length of her lunge to make sure that she stayed in bounds.
So we are just about halfway done here as Rose Domanoski had a solid routine for Brown on the beam. One of the Bears' better scores. As you get a look at Emma Hansen, the freshman out of Cincinnati, Ohio. Emma has had a season-best 9-7 on the beam.
Nice series there. Really secure in that backhand spring layout step out. Good, clean, full turn.
And it looks like Caroline is ready here on floor exercise with Morgan Lane. As we said, the back end for Carolina on Saturday here on floor exercise was outstanding. Morgan Lane getting a 9.925 2 days ago. Excellent double pike to start.
And I challenge our viewers to see if you can make it through this routine without smiling, because it's difficult. Look at that layout step out connected right out of that Rudy.
And that 9.925 she had on Saturday tied her career best.
Beautiful landing there.
Good 1.5 twist to finish it.
Great routine for Morgan. We've been seeing her getting even crisper on her landings throughout the season, and I think that's going to keep her in that 9-9 range.
Brown, meanwhile, has been very strong the last two performances as we shifted to Morgan Lane. Emma Hansen with a 9-7, so you have a 9-7-5 and 9-7 the last two for the Bears as you get a look at Reagan Butchness, a senior out of Barrington, Illinois, who has earned first-team USAG All-America on the balance beam.
And again, Brown, these athletes at the end of the lineup are in a must-hit situation because they have that 9-3 from earlier in the rotation from Cassidy Jung they're trying to drop. good connection there on her leap to jump series. And she does a really cool layout to 2 feet, much more difficult than that layout step out, and handled that one really well.
We'll transition back to floor exercise as Madison Nettles is next up for Carolina. She took first place on Saturday on floor exercise with this routine, a career best 9.95, which meant she got... Both judges gave her a score just short of a 10.
This is a critical pass for her. This is her new pass for this year, whip to double twist. Wow, 2 foot stick. That's exactly what she did at NC State on Saturday. Nice 1.5 to that double stag jump. She, you know, I can't say enough good things about Madison. She's been one of the athletes. She's been consistent her entire time at Carolina. Came in as a transfer, but she's really picked up like a half a tenth on each event throughout her time here.
And Brown has been very good here on the balance beam. 9.775 for Reagan Butchness. As you see, Julia Green, who's been their star performer for the Bears today, getting the best scores both on the vault and on floor exercise.
And really nice leap there. It takes a lot of risk whenever you take your tilt your head back and lose sight of the beam. Oh, too bad. I was just going to say, she has a lot of original elements in this routine. I think she probably just got a little bit ahead of herself. Again, those forward elements can be difficult because you lose sight of the beam. Her dismount is a real highlight here, though. This is a souk-style dismount. Get ready for this. So cool. Really too bad to see her fall, but she's such a beautiful athlete on that event.
And now we get to Kaja Hislop here on floor exercise. We said the back end of this rotation on Saturday took 1, 2, and 3 in this event. And Kaja Hislop earlier this year, I think it was the Temple meet, she did get, one of the judges did give her a 10.
One of the highest double backs in the country. Beautiful job for Kaj. You know, just a little bit of extra power on that first pass, but she is so money on that event.
As we transition back to the balance beam, one exhibition performance, and it's from Diana Manzano, the sophomore who has competed earlier for the Bears.
Slightly overturned her full turn there. Oh, and good recovery. It looked like she missed her foot a little bit there going into her dismount, but she did finish the full twist, so good routine for her.
So the Tar Heels will now have a couple of exhibition performances, and one of them is from their fourth senior, Lauren Weissel, who at the start of the year was leading Carolina off on floor exercise. But as we said, Madison Hargrave has really fought her way into the rotation, and a good double back. It was usually Lauren who set the table for Carolina here on floor exercise, but so far the last several weeks, Tar Heels have been on fire, and they are at it again today.
A nice 1.5 to front layout, and we can confirm the unofficial total for UNC on floor, 49.4. So keeping up that really high pace from Saturday. The depth of this floor team is absolutely incredible. They're the number 7 floor team in the country right now, ranked just behind Oregon State, just ahead of schools like Washington, Boise State, Alabama. So they're really up there with the top teams in the country, and that's why it's a task to make it into this UNC floor lineup.
Yes, and as I was going to say that because... as you said, the teams that are they're ahead of, but the teams that are behind them, that are in front of Carolina, I mean, you're talking about the nationally ranked teams that will compete for the national championship. You're looking at Florida, UCLA, Oklahoma that they saw a couple weeks ago, LSU, Utah. They've gotten scores in the 49 sixes, best score so far this year. I believe it was on national television when UCLA competed. They had a 49.675.
That's right. Yes. And, you know, one of the things about this, the UNC floor team, they really have, they're so consistent. They've honed their landings. What they need to do now is just take some of that consistency to their other events where they're struggling a little bit, and we're going to see them in the 196s consistently. They're not going to hit 196 today. They came in with a 146, and even UNC's floor team isn't good enough to go 50, all 10s. Even UNC's team can't do that. But, you know, I think that's one of the things. It's really great to see them succeeding on this because they have been working on the little details. They are a team that's really good at the power events on vault and on floor. And we're going to see the second exhibition here from Jamie and Nori.
Jamie out of Park City, Utah. Was in the rotation a couple times last year. Did compete in Los Angeles against the Bruins.
Yeah. whip half to front pike. Doesn't quite have the difficulty as some of the other athletes in the rotation, but she's got great execution on her skills. Double back to end there. Really solid rotation from start to finish for Carolina.
So Carolina keeping up with the Joneses. As we said a moment at the start of this rotation, the Tar Heels had a 49.425, one of the best scores in recent memory. And today, it is nearly a carbon copy, 49-4. And the rotation that Coach Galvin put out was so consistent. Four of Carolina's gymnasts had a 9.875. One with a 9.9, and that was Kaja Hislop. And Carolina comes out, obviously, with a team score of 195.4. Which is a step down from what they've put in the last few weeks. But again, it's a chance to get another solid score in, because now they're coming into a bye week and they've got a couple of big road meets in the future.
That's right. I think that, again, it's not where they want to be. They want to go. I talked to senior basketball coach.
I would try to exercise, but it was so easy to overdo it. And then you're completely and totally wiped out for days. And you can't get back.
It's hard when they open the doors of the hospital your last day and you're out on your own. And you're free to go exercise. You can go back to the gym.
Going to let them drop one of those scores in the 194s. So they've got things to work on.
I was very intimidated.
And
I didn't have my hair. And I didn't have a lot of strength. I didn't know where to begin.
The first day, we all came in here and we all started to get to know each other.
And as you said, at the beginning of the year, they had that
solid, so much fun.
They
meet you right where you're at. They strap a heart rate monitor on you. And they slowly increase the amount of exercise so that when you go home at night.
And now they can drop that.
Yeah. And it's all, again, if you're used to watching other collegiate sports, like, say, basketball, it's very different because the records do not matter. What matters is the scores. So what they really want to do is keep building on those scores and make sure that they can count all of their scores being 195 or above so they can go in securing their spot for regionals.
And I think the other thing that's keeping this momentum going is the quality of competition that they face. As we said, over the last 2 weeks, they've faced top-notch competition. They've faced Oklahoma in Norman, Oklahoma being the number one team in the country. They took on Michigan, and that was, a tight, meet against both the Wolverines and the Wolfpack, as they had that score of, in the 196 range. Well, Michigan had a 196.775, NC State had a 196.575, so it was a really good quality meet all around that they were able to fight back, from that poor performance on the bars to get into the 196s. And again, today, even though it was against Brown, they had a score of 195. Coming up next in their future, they're going down to Tuscaloosa to take on Alabama, who is been an excellent gymnastics program for generations. So that's going to be a fun experience for the Tar Heels.
Yeah, that's going to be, you know, they're on a bye next week. Then they go down to Alabama. That's going to be a difficult environment for them to compete in because Alabama, one of those SEC powerhouses, they pack their stadium, and it's a really difficult environment to compete in. So it's going to be a really good experience for them because, as you mentioned, going into the postseason, that's what the environments are likely going to look like. So I think that they can be proud of their performance. And, you know, I think also Brown had a strong performance. They're going to be able to drop that the sub 190 score they're carrying around from the beginning of the season. So that's going to be really important for them and a confidence builder going into the Ivy Classic that they have next week.
Yes, Brown will, their focus, as you said, will be the Ivy Classic and the ECAC championships, and hopefully they'll have a quality scores that will get them to the USAG championships for their postseason. Carolina will also be heading west to Tucson, Arizona to take on U of A. You also will be taking on San Jose State and the Air Force Academy. Carolina will have one final meet at home, and that will be on March 17th against the Pitt Panthers. And Pitt is always a team that, you know, is kind of in the same spot that Carolina has been in the last few years, where their ranking, you know, their RQS score is in that area where they're one of the last few teams fighting for that regional spot.
That's right. And so that's going to be a critical meet. Hopefully, you know, actually UNC has pretty solid road scores that they can use right now. They could use another strong 195 or 196 from Alabama. And then Pitt will be looking for a good road score as well to use for their RQS. And it's also a good way for the teams to judge how are they doing against their EAGL competitors, because after they compete against Pitt, they'll be going to the EAGL championships. That's the last meet before regionals.
And as we said earlier, the EAGL championships, with the way that the teams are stacked in the national rankings, that conference championship is up in the air. You could see, obviously, GW will be the favorite, you know, because they have been the most consistent team, but New Hampshire has put in a good score. Carolina, if they can hit, you know, those spots that we have mentioned, they could step over both and possibly win it. NC State has gotten better and better over the year.
Yeah, NC State had a season high in the mid-196s at their quad meet, so it's really going to be anyone's game at the EAGL championships. If Carolina does want a chance to win that, they do really need to improve their consistency. That's really the issue with Carolina, particularly on beam and on bars.
Looks like all that is left is the awards ceremonies. So we will step aside for just a moment as the teams will come out. And it looks like that's what we're going to right now as we look at the PA as we start on vault. And all four of those Tar Heels were the best performers for Carolina on the vault. Leading the way was Madison Hargrave, setting a personal best, 9.825. Very consistent performance for Carolina.
And, you know, one of the things, all of these athletes had great dynamics in their vaults, just really need to hone in on those landings, get the stuck landings to move into the high 9.8s, 9.9 range.
Next, our top finishers on uneven bars. In a three-way tie for third with a score of 9.75, from the University of North Carolina, Madison Nettles, Morgan Lane, and Alexis Allen.
So three Tar Heels getting a tie for third position.
From Brown, Kate Nelson.
And Kate Nelson, that was a real treat. She had one of the most difficult routines. had a beautiful dismount as well.
And Caitlin Headland leading the way, having a season best 9.85. We said it during that routine, she was trying to crack that score of 9.8, and she over 9.8, and she did it today.
And great to see her recover from that fall at state over the weekend.
And now for our top finishers on balance beam. In third place with a score of 9.775, from Brown, Regan Blitchness.
And Brown really performed well on the balance beam for the second time in 3 days.
And Regan Butchness, one of their really consistent competitors.
From the University of North Carolina, Kasia Hislop and Morgan Lane.
And both Kasia and Morgan have been so consistent for UNC throughout the season. We've seen them go a little bit higher into that, you know, high 9.8, 9.9 range. But those routines were really critical for Carolina because they were following falls, so it was a really must-hit situation.
Caitlin Headland also did well setting the table with that 9.75. And we head to the awards for floor exercise, and it's going to be all Carolina, as we said. They kept with the Joneses.
Yeah, this
Tar Heels with a 9.875.
They were just on the 9.875 train, I think. Really strong performances. As I mentioned on Saturday, had three athletes go 9.9 or above this week. Kasia was the only one that hit that 9.9 mark, but having four athletes go 9.875 just speaks to the consistency and the potential of the floor lineup.
And it started with Madison, though, too. She set her personal best of 9.825.
Exactly.
Yeah. And just everyone else down the line.
When you can drop a 9.825, you're doing pretty well.
Yes.
So that's great to see them really hone in on the landings. The extension in their leaps was wonderful. And so they're in a really good place on floor exercise.
I believe there was only one performer on all around, and that was Morgan Lane.
Yeah, she did. She had a great performance. Also, fairly easy to win the all around competition since she was the only one competing. But, you know, she's so consistent for the Tar Heels and continues to do that week in, week out.
And now the team standings. In second place with a score of 192.1, the Brown Bears.
192.1 for Brown. That's about on their mark, just shy of their mark at NC State last week. On Saturday, they got a 192.45. UNC not quite hitting that 196, but getting a solid 195 to count for their RQS.
Yes, a 195.4 for Carolina. The Tar Heels did a lot of work this past weekend, competing in two meets in 3 days. I think the coaches and the gymnasts will be happy that they will have a bye week, and as we talked about earlier, they will have a tough road schedule in front of them, traveling to Tuscaloosa and also to Tucson in a quad meet, but they will be back here at Carmichael Arena on Senior Day on March 17th at 1 p.m. So far, our entire crew here at Carmichael Arena, and for my broadcast partner, Christina Chauvinet, it's been a pleasure here on ACC Network Extra to present Carolina Gymnastics as the Tar Heels defeat the Brown Bears with a score of 195.4 to 192.1. To watch this broadcast and all other broadcasts on our platform of ESPN Networks, go to watchespn.com or download the Watch ESPN app. Thanks for watching, and good night from Chapel Hill.